reason must. What difference does it make if you're training here or outside or any place? You still train, don't you?
I ain't gonna do it. I ain't gonna train indoors no more. I just ain't gonna do it, that's all.
But look, Muggs, you got a chance to be the champ of the Golden Gloves this year, ain't you?
Yeah, I got a chance, all right, but I ain't gonna get to train that stubby old hole up there. I gotta do like the rest of the champs do it. You seen them in the newsreels. They got a big camp, they got fresh air, place to their road work.
Yeah, so, sure, I get it. That takes dough and plenty of it. Where are we gonna get that?
That's up to you boys. I do the fighting, you do the worrying, see?
Yeah, I see. I got it. A training camp in the country. Good food, fresh air, a lot of sleep, plenty of rest.
Wait a minute, I just said all that. But how are we gonna get it?
Don't worry about it, leave that to me. You do the fighting, I'll do the worrying.
Well, right. When do we get to my new training camp?
It won't be long now.
Still don't get the angle. How'd you fix it, Danny?
It was a cinch.
Hey, nothing's too good for the Golden Gloves runner-up.
I hope it's pretty soon. I'm hungry.
Hey, I didn't get a chance to read all them papers I was signing. Who's paying for all this anyhow?
Don't worry about it, will you? Everything's taken care of. Sure thing, Muggs. Danny's got us all in right.
It ain't costing us a cent. We might even get paid.
Paid? Oh, that's swell. I'll work the gate on a percentage basis. I'll see that you guys get a cut, too.
That's swell of you, Muggs.
Time.
This is really a nice spot. A beautiful layout, I calls it. What's a gymnasium, boys? Nice bunch of sparring partners. Well, what do we do now? Come on, let's get going. You're wasting time. Hey, bud, get my bags. Will you get a shower ready? Come on, let's get organized around here. Come on, fellas.
Hey, you know you're not supposed to throw papers on the ground. Pick it up. Come on, make it snappy.
Hey, wait a minute. You don't have to pick it up unless he wants to.
Yes, he does. It's a camp rule.
Camp rule, huh? Well, I'm making the rules on it from now on. This is my camp, see?
I'm sorry, but if you're going to stay here, you're going to have to do as you're told.
I slay you off. You get yourself in trouble.
It's all right. I'm going to stay around all right, but I'm going to do the telling. How do you like that?
I don't like it. Do you?
I must have tripped. Now it's my turn. I'll tear that guy apart. Boom! I'm going to tear him apart.
What's the matter? Save it later.
Yeah, what's the guy think he is, a fighter?
I don't know, but you always wanted a tough sparring partner. Well, now you got one. Take it easy, will you? Straighten up. That's more like it.
Scrinell, show these boys their bunks.
Yes, sir.
Put your bags away and report for your physical.
Any trouble?
I don't believe there'll be any more, Captain.
I hope you're right. Make sure they get their physical.
Yes, sir.
Gee, mister, thanks
that
a lot.
Beat it. And pick up the bags.
Pick up the bag.
Hey, get the bag. That's me.
Can you imagine such a thing? Look over the guy's shoulder when he plugs me. Boy, I'll keep him alone one of these days. I'll hit him so hard I'll break his ankles. Yeah, imagine a thing like that.
Hey, how much longer are we going to be able to kid Muggs about this place?
I don't know, but I sure hope he sees it the way the rest of the fellas do when he finds out.
He won't.
After he's in a while and realizes that his mother's going to get that $22 a month for support, he'll like it. I know my mother's glad she's going to get the dough.
Yeah, but Muggs is going to have to work. I know he won't like that.
put me around here? What do they think I am, an octopus? I ain't got but two hands. Gotta give me part of this. I'm getting sick of this. They work me around here till I'm black in the face.
Yeah, I never saw so many beds in my life. And they're all made, too. What are these for, my sparring partners?
Yeah.
Well, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to start numbering them. See, I'll put the odd ones on this side, the even ones on that side. We'll start tomorrow morning, see, and we're going to start up with an odd number. You know, one
this way, yes. Right this way. Right down.
Yeah, we're coming.
Come on, right here.
Yeah, they're going to save us. Yeah, you have the hot and cold running water here.
Yeah, we got everything here you might need.
At the room service.
Oh, everything's all right.
That's good.
I got to get there.
Where's the track for a little workout? In case I want to make a little workout, where's the track? All right, kid, you can come out now. Drop those bags.
All right. Well, now, look, you take that one, and one can take this one over here, and that one...
Wait a minute. I made a private room with a bed.
Well, I don't know nothing about that.
Don't worry about that now. We'll fix it up later. And so we're here for a while. Hey, listen, we gotta have beds all together, see?
Well, all I know is you gotta take bunks where there ain't nobody else sleeping.
Yeah?
We can put you boys close together. Some of the other fellas won't mind giving up their bunks.
Hey, you're softening up already, huh?
Lay off, Muggs.
The doctor's waiting. You better get over for your physical exam.
Physical? You don't make me laugh. Just look me over, that's all.
If you're afraid.
Afraid ain't afraid of nothing. Where's that doc? Lead me to him.
Follow me.
That's all, son.
Never mind those guys, Doc. I'm the one you're looking for.
Quiet. Vaccinated lately?
Sure, take a look.
You'll get another shot. That's all.
Thanks, Doctor. Hey, Doc, what's new?
Vaccinated lately?
Vaccinated? Look at that physique. I don't need no vaccination.
You'll get a shot anyway.
Right, but I won't
That's
like
all.
It.
Vaccinated?
Yes.
Hey, lay off, will you, Mums? You want to get us in trouble?
What's the matter? Ain't we supposed to be big shots around here? Hey, Doc, this stuff is awful. It must be spoiled.
This is too much. Report to the captain.
Look how excited he gets. Over nothing he gets excited.
I said report to the captain.
Okay. All right. A couple of things I got to tell my captain anyway. I don't like the way he's running this place. Have a drink, bud. Hey, Stooge, get my shirt, will you?
I'm sure sunk now.
Maloney? Your case has been investigated by the Welfare Board, and they've certified that your mother is in need of the $22 monthly allotment, which will be paid to her. As far as the government is concerned, that's the reason that you're here.
You mean this is a CCC camp, and I gotta stay here for 6 months?
Didn't you know what you were signing? Of course, if there's been any misunderstanding, and you can get a better position, we'll give you a discharge. There are certain rules here that'll be explained to you. They're for the good of all. Anyone who violates them gives the other fellows a bad break. We also have school at night here. Many of the boys have found fine positions from what they've learned here.
That's very nice.
That's all, Maloney.
Yes, sir.
Hey, here he comes.
So, this is a training camp, huh? You guys fix everything. Yeah, you're gonna fix everything. I'm gonna train for nothing.
Now, wait a minute, Muggs. Listen, we had to do this. You wouldn't work or train or nothing. This way you can send your mother $22 a month. She needs it. Listen to me, will you?
It's only for a little while, Muggs. It'll put you in swell shape.
Sure, you'll be a champ. We had to sign up, too, just to be with you.
Yeah, and I suppose you're gonna stick with me, too. Well, let me tell you something, you double-crosser. The joke's on you, see? I just had a talk with the captain, and him and me are just like that. I'll own this camp in a week, and I'm staying, and you guys are staying with me. What's more, I'm gonna take that bed.
Yeah, that's my book. Okay, you can have that one, Muggs. I'll even show you where to put your clothes.
What's that for?
That's first call for retreat.
Retreat from what?
You remember how they told us they'd take down the flag and we saluted? Come on, we gotta get going.
All right, what are you waiting for? Come on.
Come on.
Make them shoot. shoulders. Put out that chin. Straighten that arm.
When'd you learn about all this saluting stuff?
What do you think, I'm dumb? I used to bash a soldier bike. Hey, when do we eat?
Ready! Come on!
They feed you like this and pay you, too.
How long has this been going on? Why don't somebody tell me these things?
Hey, what's the matter with you?
There's a fly annoying me.
Point him out to me and I'll murder him.
Hey, pass the bread.
Pass the bread.
That's what I like to see.
Hey,
what are you, wise guy? Give me the
bread.
Can I have a piece of bread, fellas?
Ain't he cute?
Yeah, ain't I cute?
Oh, ain't I cute?
I'm cute.
Hey, quiet, you fellas. Cut it out.
Hey, lay off, Muggs. Lay off.
Muggs, come here.
It's a pleasure.
Attention.
What's the trouble, Alan?
Nothing, sir. Just a little misunderstanding about the bunks.
Any complaints to make?
No, sir.
Have you any complaints?
No, sir.
Fix your bunks and get into them. That's all.
Hey, that was pretty square of you, Al, not squealing.
Oh, forget it.
But you and me still got to settle this thing.
That suits me.
Hey, you shouldn't have socked him.
Yeah, I was just taking the kinks out of my arm, that's all. Now if I can get a little road work in the morning.
I think that can be arranged very nicely.
No, I don't like the way he said that.
Roadway. You asked for it.
Yeah, yeah, Fritz. Where did I get a hold of that guy, Al? Hey, where's Pee-wee this morning? I didn't see him working.
He's on a sick report.
A sick report? How do you ever fix that?
All he does is go walking into the dock and say,
you couldn't get away with that.
No?
I'm gonna. Stop making me laugh.
Just wait till we go in for lunch this afternoon. I'm gonna walk right up to the dock and I'm gonna say, Doc, my jaw's awful sore this afternoon.
So they'll give you a cough drop.
Well, here goes.
Man, ain't you gonna eat first?
Nah, maybe the doctor's gonna give me a special diet.
Think it'll help, and he can mention my name.
What's it say, doctor?
108.
Is that good?
Where does it hurt the most?
Right here. I mean here. Right here.
You can't leave the camp this afternoon. I'll give you a note to give to the foreman.
Thanks a lot, doctor.
That's all right, son. I'm here to do all I can for you boys.
Yes, sir.
Maybe they put him in solitary, huh?
It worked! It worked! It worked! No kid, no kid!
Okay, let's go.
I can't.
Why?
You're in a bad way, aren't you?
Yeah, pretty bad.
Hold it until I take care of the semblance. Here's what the doctor ordered. Exercise.
But you mean I...
All right, big boy. Hop to it. Go on.
But these are trees.
Take it away.
Come on, get that one cut there. Don't wait too hard. Get out of the way. Oh, yeah.
What kind of job those fellas up there got?
Oh, that's the forestry crew working. You know, someday those boys are going to get a good job with the government.
I'd go nuts with a job like that myself. How'd he roll along with the birds and the trees? That ain't for me.
Take five!
Take five what?
That means 5 minutes rest.
Rest? Oh, that's great. Hey, boys, want to go up and see that tree fall?
Okay.
Come on, let's go.
That's really gonna make some noise when it goes.
Man, look at them chips fly.
You all right?
Yeah, I guess so.
Yeah, you gotta be a little more careful where you're walking next time.
You all right, Muggs?
Yeah,
you guys okay?
Yeah, I'm all right.
Gee, that was quick thinking, fella.
That was nothing.
Ah, gee, Muggs, that was swell of you. I sure had you wrong.
Anybody would have done the same thing. That don't mean you and me still ain't got some things to settle between us, see?
Hey, we'll let the captain decide that. That's all for today. Come on, boys.
You could have put no little dent in my skull.
No matter how you feel about it, Maloney, it was a very brave act. You deliberately risked your life to save another's.
It wasn't nothing.
Oh, yes, it was. You saw what had to be done, and you did it, regardless of the risk. You know, you're a lot better man than you even think you are.
Quit your kidding, will you?
I'm not. I was never more serious in my life. I think this camp is going to be the means of your finding yourself.
Go on, I ain't even lost.
I feel that you should be granted something in return. Oh, not exactly a reward, but rather an extra privilege. Now, what would you like?
I'd like to have a chance to square things with this owl guy.
All right, put up the ring. That ought to settle it.
Yes, sir.
Come on, we gotta make plans.
Yeah.
Thanks, Captain.
How are you?
Fine, Captain. How are you?
Okay.
What's all the activity about?
Private fight.
Oh, mind if I stay and look it over?
No, not at all. Come on. It's going to be a good one.
By the way, here's some passes for the fight Wednesday night. Thought some of the kids might like to see them.
Thanks, Norton. You know, you've been mighty nice to the boys around here.
Well, I'm getting a free pass for one of their private fights.
Private is right.
Now, remember what I tell you, Muggs. Carry the fight to them. But go easy. That right hand of his is packed full of dynamite. So feel him out for the first round.
Hey, what do you think? They let me join the cook school.
Boy, will I eat now.
Yeah, running out of me, huh? I suppose Skinny will be next. All he's been doing...
Forget about it. We got more important things to think about. Come on, I'm going to see if they're set yet. Come on.
What's the matter, kid? What's the matter? Don't you feel good? If you're worried about me, you don't have to. I'll take the guy like a camera taking a picture.
It's not that, Muggs. I can't tell you.
Oh, come on, unload. You'll feel better.
I just can't tell you. I gotta take it by myself.
We're pals, ain't we?
Yeah.
Well, then come on. Maybe I can help you.
Would you, Muggs?
Sure thing.
It's my brother. My aunt's been taking care of us since we were little kids. We ain't got any parents. My brother got in a jam, Muggs. He needs a lot of dough quick, and I don't know where to get it or where to go or...
Well, you can't get no money up here. What's the matter? Haven't they been sending home that $22 a month?
Yeah, but it ain't enough. He needs a lot of dough, and he needs it quick, and I don't know where to go.
All right, quit fooling. We'll work something out together.
Gee, you're a swell fella, Muggs.
That makes two of us to think so.
Hey, Muggs!
Yeah?
Come on, they're ready.
Okay, be right there. Come on, kid, I'll let you watch a first-class slaughter.
corner we have Battling Arab. And in this corner we have Tiger Mugs.
Now, fellas, the number one thing, this has got to be a clean fight, break clean, and may the best man win. Okay.
Remember, go out there and spar and look out for that right of his. It's awful. Yeah, it's in the back. I ain't even started yet. Kid's in bad condition. Said he's putting all over the joint.
Go out there and kill him.
Go do it, Muggs.
Save them that time. Get them next time.
Yeah, see you in about 3 seconds.
I didn't even win the game.
That's
go to it.
Boys, but it'll never reach a decision. I'm calling it a draw.
I ain't draw. Give me 2 more minutes with him.
No, one of you might get hurt.
Well, it's gonna be him. See, we're gonna fight this thing out.
That's fine, little Maloney. Shake hands.
All right, fellas, step lively. Come on. All right, get up there, quick. Up in front. Let's go. All right, get up this row here. Let's go. All right, come on. Hey, you. You're not going out with the gang today.
Why? What's the matter?
Orders.
Orders, huh? Well, maybe I need a rest. Maybe I'm working too hard, huh? That's fine, thanks.
All right, let's load up.
Hey, Willie. You went where I can eat it. I'm on vacation myself, you know. Hey, what's eating you?
Well, I... Cut it out, Willie. You know the orders.
What is this, anyway? Hi, fellas. Going out to do some road work? You treat me like I was the forgotten man. I wonder what's wrong with the fellows today, Captain. They all treat me as though I got smallpox or something.
The boys have decided to punish you for your bad sportsmanship last night. They don't like it, and this is their way of showing it.
You mean they ain't gonna talk to me or nothing?
That's it. However, you can work off your punishment on that wood pile over there.
Yes, sir. Suppose you're in on it, too.
I am not. Never mind those other guys. They can't take it. Show them you can.
That's nice of you, Danny. You'll have to get in trouble even talking to me.
I get in trouble. So what? We're still pals, ain't we?
Yeah. Yeah. Hey! My eyes deceiving me? Wait a minute, son. Got a little business to do out here.
Wait a minute. You know women and fighting don't mix.
Who says anything about fighting with her? Hiya, babe.
Well, hello.
Hey, how would you like me to show you around the place personally?
Why, I think that would be very nice.
Well, you do, huh? It'll take me a little while to get dialed up. Will you wait here about 5 minutes?
Well, do you think the captain would approve?
The captain? It's between you and me. I got a job here through politics. Just wrote to a couple of congressmen friends of mine.
Oh, is that so?
Yeah, yeah.
Well, that's very interesting.
It is, huh? Well, you just wait here. I'll be right back. See, now don't leave. You just wait right there.
Yes, thank you. Goodbye. Oh, hello, Elaine. Thought you said you couldn't make it today.
Well, I'm here. I just met the most amusing boy outside.
You did? Who is he?
He's the young man who got you your job here. Through great political influence.
Political? Oh, that couldn't be anybody but Muggs Maloney.
Well, whoever it is, he certainly is running around out of control.
No, not entirely. The boy has some good stuff in him. Only it has to be brought out the hard way.
What do you mean?
Really has to learn how to fight it out with himself instead of fighting with others.
You know, I think he's the type who'd respond more quickly to kind treatment.
Do you want the job?
I've already taken it. He's meeting me here in 5 minutes to show me around the camp.
Well, don't blame me if you get your feelings right.
Thank you.
Hey, this is sure a lot of country to be all in one place, ain't it?
Yes, it is. And it's a wonderful country, too. Men are doing great things here. Men who just a few years ago were boys like you.
Hey, cut it out, will you, babe? That ain't what I came here to talk about.
No? What are your ideas?
Well, Say, you live in town, don't you?
Yes.
Yeah, well, it's fine.
How would you like to come and visit me some afternoon?
Oh, I'd like that. Yeah, sure would.
All right, it's, 37 Pine Avenue, just a few blocks from the center of town.
Well, I'll be there. I'll be there pretty quick, you see. All I'll have to do is I got a few things to talk to the captain about first, and then, you just put out the welcome mat and sit on the stoop. I mean, I'll be there later. Captain, excuse me. Could I come in?
Why, certainly, Muggs. Come right in.
Captain, I've been thinking things over, and, well, I'd like to reform. Well, I mean, I've been causing a lot of trouble since I came to camp and having arguments and things. From now on, I mean, I'd like to try to get along with the fellas, you know, kind of turn over a new leaf. That's about it, I guess.
Well, I'm mighty glad to hear you say that, Muggs.
Thanks, Captain. Thanks. Say, do you think, could I go to town Saturday?
Well, I wasn't going to let you, but after what you said, you can go.
Thanks, Captain, thanks. You won't be sorry.
Why didn't you tell us you were going into town today?
You said I was.
Nobody needs to say so. Look at you.
And we refused leave so as to be here with you.
Well, that's your tough luck.
I know where you're going. You're going down to see the fight manager in town.
Yeah, that's it. The fight manager got a little business talk over him. That's why I got to go alone, see?
No.
Oh, you don't, huh? Well, don't worry about me, boys. I'll be right back.
Flowers, get nice fresh flowers here picked this morning. Fresh flowers? Anyone here? Flowers, mister? Oh, they're nice. Very lovely. Yes, indeed. Flowers, step right up, folks, get brand new.
Hey, what's in bloom, son?
Well, we got some nice sweet peas.
What are you doing here, Scruno?
Well, I'm just making some extra folding money on my day off.
How much are they?
2 bits.
That's fine, I owe you.
Oh, no. That's 2 bits to you, too.
How much?
15 cents.
I can't hear you so good.
All right, a dime.
That's much better. That's much better. Hey, where's Pine Street?
2 blocks down and 1 block over.
Yeah, you can make the profit up on the next customer.
Yeah? Well, listen, it don't make no difference, see, because I got these out of the neighbor's yard. Hey, flowers, step right up, folks.
Give me my money back.
Why should I? What's the matter?
If the girl was out, that's why you should. Anyhow, they don't smell so good.
But they did a while ago.
How would you like me to tell the neighbors where all the flowers is disappearing to?
Oh, blackmail.
You want me to tell?
It's all right with me, because next week I'm in the watermelon business.
Thank you.
Hello, Maloney. Gonna look us over tonight?
Yeah, just wandering around.
That was a great fight you put on the other day.
Yeah. Yeah, it was pretty good, wasn't I?
Got a spot for you if you want to go on tonight.
I guess not. Thanks just the same.
Well, if you change your mind, come on back.
Again, you're not be afraid of me. Oh, what's the matter with you? What have you been up to?
Nothing.
Quit lying.
I'm in an awful jam, Muggs.
All right, spill it.
I swiped $100 from the captain's office.
$100?
Yeah.
Well, we gotta get it back there.
We can't.
Why?
I sent it to my aunt.
Sent it to your aunt?
Yeah.
How did you ever expect to get away with that?
I didn't. I was scrambling when you caught up with me. You gotta help me, Muggs. You gotta get
what
me out of...
What do you expect me to do, take the rap for you?
No, but I figured you might be able to get me out of...
$100, huh?
Yeah.
$100. Yeah. Yeah, maybe I can raise that.
Yeah?
Maybe I can. But you and me will settle this business later, see? Come on! Hey, Mr. Norton. How about that, Bob?
Oh, so you did change your mind, eh?
Yeah, yeah, how about it?
All right, go on to the dressing room.
Thanks. I gotta have $100.
Say, what do you think this is, the big time?
No, no, but I gotta have it. No, later on I'll fight a couple of free ones for you, but tonight I just gotta have $100.
All right, I'll give you $100 if you stay 6 rounds, and from now on I handle you.
Yeah, but I gotta manage you, eh? All right, okay, it's a deal.
Muggs.
He didn't want us to, did he?
Quit worrying, will you? He's probably having a lot better time right now than we are.
Kid, I'm going to have to yank you.
No, you're not. This fight's going 6 rounds.
Yeah.
Now, listen, you're too good a boy. I don't want you to get hurt. I'll give you the 100. Quit worrying.
Nothing doing. I've been double crossed once today. You said 6 rounds, and I'm sticking.
Yeah.
But I shouldn't have let you do it.
What do you mean? Next time I'll take him. He's just lucky, that's all.
Sure, sure. You'll take him the next time. Hey, Muggs, how are we going to get back to the camp?
I'll send you back in my car, boys.
Gee, thanks.
Don't worry,
You sure you got it now, Muggs? It's the key in the top left-hand drawer of the desk.
Top left-hand drawer?
Yeah. Gee, Muggs, I'm the one that should go in there now, but I'm scared to go in there.
You'd only mess things up anyway.
Yeah.
You'd be the lookout.
Is it?
What's wrong?
Nothing.
Come on, something's wrong. Spill it.
Nothing, I tell you. Nothing.
Are you going to tell me what's wrong?
Nothing.
Come on, what is it?
Muggs was caught robbing the safe.
Robbing the safe? Muggs never stole nothing in his life.
Muggs, I'm willing to give you every break. Haven't you anything to say for yourself?
I guess not. You caught me and, well, that's it, ain't it?
Muggs, you didn't do it, did you?
Now you keep out of this.
But he didn't do it. He ain't no crook.
I've given him every chance to speak in his own defense, and he's refused. Tomorrow you'll appear at a formal hearing. Unless you have something to offer in your own defense at that time, I'll be forced to give you a dishonorable discharge. That's all.
Yes, sir.
Why won't you talk, Muggs? We know you didn't do it. Where are you going? Ain't you going to stay for the trial?
Yeah, baloney, that trial stuff. I'm leaving right now.
Oh, but where are you going to go? What are you going to do?
I can take care of myself.
Oh, sure you can, Muggs, but this is different. We ain't never been separated before. There's something wrong about the whole thing.
Gee, Muggs, I'm awfully sorry about what... Maybe I ought to.
Skip it, kid. I've been in jams before, and I got out of them, and I'll get out of this one.
Oh, sure you can, but what'll your mother think?
My mother won't know anything about it, unless you squeal.
Oh, I ain't gonna squeal, but where you gonna go?
I told you before, I've been in lots of jams.
Yeah, but not for stealing.
Muggs, I thought you were going to come and see me.
I did. She was out.
Oh, I'm sorry. Well, how about coming now?
Eh, gotta see a man about a job.
You wouldn't refuse a lady, would you? Besides, I really want to talk to you.
Well, if you insist. But I can't stay for long. Stopping here for?
Listen, Muggs, why don't you go back and have a talk with the captain?
He said all there was to say the other night.
He doesn't think so.
Well, what do you mean?
Captain White had a lot of faith in you, Muggs, and he still wants to have. He thinks there's something behind all this that you're not telling him about.
How could there be anything behind it? He saw me there, that dough was in my mitt and the safe was open.
What is it, Muggs? Why don't you tell me? Is it worth giving up everything for? What about Danny and your pals? Think how hard you're making it for them.
cut it out, will you? I think I'd better go.
I wish you wouldn't.
Well, I gotta see Mr. Norton about a fight. You know, now that the government ain't supporting me, I gotta keep expenses down.
Muggs, please. Muggs! Talk to him, Jim. It's no use. He stuck to his story. But I could see that underneath his heart was breaking, not because he's guilty, but because there's something he can't or won't tell.
I felt the same way about it. But if he won't tell the truth, what are we going to do?
Excuse me, Captain. Can I see you for a minute? It's very important.
Subby, come right in, Danny.
Well, it's like this. We've all been pretty dumb, especially me.
How, Danny?
Well, the other night, when something woke me up, I thought it was Muggs. But it wasn't. It was Willie, just coming to bed.
Yes?
It was late, and he was still dressed. Now, how did he know what had happened? He told me what Muggs was doing before anybody else in the camp knew about it. Why was he dressed? And how did he know?
Well, suppose we ask Willie those questions.
Yes, sir, I'll get him.
Hey, Willie! Captain wants to see you.
Money, sir. I was running away when Muggs caught me. He wants money fighting in town and was putting it back in the safe.
What did you do with the money?
I hid the money in town. I told Muggs I sent it to my aunt, but I ain't got no aunt. Nothing.
Come on, what are we waiting for? We gotta find Muggs before something happens to him. He's desperate. He's lost.
Mr. Norton might know where he is.
I'll phone him. Hello, operator. Give me the Norton Fight Arena. Yes? Yes? Thank you. They say that Norton is out, but that Muggs is fighting at the arena tonight. Danny, it looks as though we're going to see a fight.
Muggsy boy, you're going green. You're even better than you were at the camp.
Hey, Yes, yeah, I told you I was good last time. I thought this guy just had an off night, that's all.
Now you're talking. Come on, okay, now, Peter. You ready to get him softened up?
Yeah, yeah, be murder this time, murder.
That's all.
You a lesson, Maloney. There are times when a man could and should talk. It's the right thing to do, and it's not squealing.
Yes, sir. I get it now, Captain.
You sure learned that the hard way.
Besides, Maloney, there's something else.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Pal, put it there, pal.
How do you like that?
I don't like it. Do you?
Here we go again, boy.